So what made me want to be a scientist? Well, I guess it was studying science at school, doing biology, chemistry, physics, but especially biology. I really loved biology while I was growing up. I think mostly because I really liked animals and insects and things like that. But also, especially, there was this one time when at secondary school, my teachers told me all about Dolly the sheep, the first ever cloned mammal. And I was like, oh, mind blown. I just wanted to know more about that, and I think it really went from there, basically. Hi, puppy. You asked me what my favorite part of my job is, and I guess the answer is finding out stuff that no one else has found out before, and just understanding stuff that I didn't understand before. So yeah, those moments when I finally just go, oh, I really get this. Or when I find something and I'm like, this is so cool. And nobody else has ever seen it before. So those are my absolute favorite parts of my job anyway. Some of you have asked me what an ovary actually is. So I thought I might actually explain. An ovary is basically an organ that lives inside the female body and is a little safe space, a little nest, just for eggs, basically. Keeps them nice and safe so that you can have babies in your adult life. Hi, Connor. You just asked me a really great question about how it is that I use chickens to study human beings and how that relates to human fertility. Well, the answer to that question is, an ovary is basically an organ that houses loads of human eggs in it. Well, when I talk about eggs, most people think about chickens anyway. Chickens lay loads and loads of eggs, and so they're a really great way of studying what happens in ovaries and when it comes to laying eggs, basically. So somebody out there asked me, what do I do all day? That's a really great question. Is that my boss? No. So I do loads of different things every day, basically. I think being a scientist is a really cool job because we get to do loads of different things every day. Some days I'm at the bench that you saw in the first clip, and I do, you know, experiments and I pipette and I, you know, really get into the nitty gritty of that stuff. Some days I have to think and read and write a lot more. Some days I spend time talking to people about it. And actually, on the whole, most days are a giant mixture of this kind of thing. It's like a fruit salad of activity. So there'll be some experiments, there'll be some analysis that I have to do to try and make sense of the data that we got from the experiments. Talking to other people about what does this actually mean? Reading up on whether or not it makes sense with what we knew before. And then if I get really lucky, obviously, I get to tell other people, hey, I found something that you might find also interesting. So what do I do every day? Depends on the day. Someone asked me whether or not it's fun working in a lab. And the answer to that is yes, absolutely. I really love working in the lab anyway. And, you know, on days like today when I'm working from home, I can't help but miss it, like, a lot. Hi, Lexi. You asked me what it is that I do to help with testing for the virus. Well, what I personally do is I take the sample from the patient, from you or me or anyone else who's been swabbed, and transfer that into a special mixture that basically kills the virus immediately. And because I'm handling the actual virus and the potential virus, it means that I have to do this work in a really big hood with like loads of protective equipment on and a lab coat and extra sleeves. But then basically after the virus has been killed dead, or the potential virus has been killed dead, the sample gets passed on to other people who basically look for the sign of the virus being in that sample. So there's a test that's done, basically. And then someone texts the results to the patients in question. One of you asked how doing the coronavirus testing is different to my everyday job. Well, it's completely different. I can't even begin to explain to you how different it is, really. But I'm gonna try. So like I said, basically doing the testing involves having to wear a lot of safety gear. Now, normally when I work at the bench, I'll be wearing a lab coat and gloves and, you know, goggles, fine, no issue. But handling a virus that's causing a current pandemic, you don't, you know, that's not really enough. So in that context, I work in a special containment unit which means that it's pressurized so that the air only moves in certain directions, meaning that it's not possible to contaminate the outside world. On top of that, we get the samples inside a hood, which is kind of like an extra box around a table that we work on. So essentially, there's two layers of security there already. So we're in a special unit hallway, basically, inside the Crick. And within that, there is a room. And inside the room, there is a hood. And inside the hood is where I put my hands. And I wear two pairs of gloves and special sleeves so that I'm extra protected. And again, there's lots of airflow. That means that there's no way that any virus could possibly come out of that space. And that's where I get the samples and put them into the solution that inactivates them, basically, that kills the virus dead and allows for my colleagues to test for whether or not the virus is or isn't in there. And that's completely different to what I do on a day-to-day basis, because normally I'm studying how do ovaries develop and, you know, analyzing my data and reading up about ovaries and chickens and fertility. So I have two cats and they're called Peanut and Princess. And this is Princess. Peanut's hiding over there somewhere. Should I go get her? I might go get her, hold on. Say hi to Peanut. Hi Pravin, you asked me about my journey to the Crick. Well, I guess I had a relatively normal journey to working at the Francis Crick Institute. I did my A-levels, I did an undergraduate degree in human genetics at the University of Nottingham, and then I did a PhD at the University of Oxford. And then I got lucky and got the job here. Well, not here exactly, this is my living room. I'm working from home today because of this pandemic. You asked me a question about the impact that my work might have on everyday life and human beings. Well, I'm very ambitious for my work. So whilst what I do is technically called basic biology or fundamental research, which means that essentially I'm just trying to understand the answer to a very simple question, in this case, how do ovaries form? The potential impact of this work is actually quite large. So most likely it's going to impact what we understand, obviously, about chickens and how they lay their eggs. But also there's a human syndrome that we're currently trying to understand a lot better with this work that I'm doing. And these patients who have this syndrome can't have children at all, pretty much. So we would understand that. And actually just understanding how an ovary works better should mean that we will understand a lot better about what happens when people can't have babies in general, what maybe has gone wrong when people get cancer in those organs, and maybe even be able to understand something better about what we do in terms of treating these things. So that's the high hopes we have for my kind of work.